FDA is going to regulate e-cigarettes and other tobacco products.
The move comes amid growing concern about the long-term health effects of e-cig vapor and increase in vaping by teens.
NBC2's Joe Rotz is here with what the new rules mean for businesses and for smokers in Southwest Florida.
The FDA has handed down a number of new mandates in the world of e-cigarettes. No free samples, as well as no sales to minors, no vending machines, and companies have to submit liquids for FDA approval. Now, I stopped at two vape shops where workers had very different opinions about these new regulations.
They're popping up across Southwest Florida. In Cape Coral alone, you can easily count up to six vape shops on Del Prado Boulevard.
It is absolutely smoking cessation, man, for sure, yeah.
Josh Merrill started working at the vape store when he quit smoking a few years back.
20 years, two packs a day. And then I came across vaping, man.
Today, he's getting wind of new regulations just handed down by the FDA. A majority of stores like his already enforce some, like no sales to minors or no vending machines. But some new requirements have him worried, like the FDA approval for the juices stores sell.
Here at the vape store, they carry 175 different flavors of e-juice. Now, the fear is that having to submit each and every one of these to the FDA for approval would cost tens of millions of dollars.
Down the street at Premier Vapor, manager Billy Romine says his team already adheres to strict FDA guidelines when manufacturing liquids.
They're airtight, they never come in contact with airborne contaminants or even human contact.
He welcomes stricter guidelines for the industry.
I'm all for the FDA monitoring the chemical makeups, the process being used to manufacture it, the facilities, more importantly, used to manufacture the products.
The ban on sales to minors will take effect in 90 days. The FDA plan does not address flavors in e-cigarettes, which many critics say entices children to try them. Kelly?